Praise the Lord, you are tuning into the media ministry of Apostle Barbara R. Thomas. This ministry is designed to bring forth revelation and encouragement and to enlighten your minds. Now listen as the woman of God brings you revelation from the Word of God.
Come on, come on, come on. Come on, give him glory. Come on, just see that the Lord is shining. I feel fire, oh God. Oh God. Surrender your mind, oh God. Oh God. For your glory. Send your mind, oh God. Oh God. I'm giving you.
Yes, me.
everybody crying tonight.
Withholding nothing,
oh God, withholding. There is a divine mandate. And the Spirit of the Lord began to deal with me. As I was coming this way, even before, the power of God was so strong. The fire of God was so intense. My whole head is on fire. And we are, and I keep hearing the Spirit of the Lord say, we're at a turning point in the kingdom of God. We're at a turning point, the most critical time of our salvation is upon us right now. And it's imperative that the people begin to hear the voice of God. I kept hearing that scripture as I was coming here. He kept telling me, my spirit's not going to strive with man always. He said, I'm going to keep pulling on the hearts of the people. And they keep rejecting me. Spirit. I saw this image of this person. And I saw this person slowly turning his back. And I began to cry out to God, don't turn your back on us. So God, if you turn away from your people, what would happen to us? If you leave us, if you turn away from us, where will we go? How can we stand? How will we be able to survive the attacks of the enemy? And the Lord gave me a scripture, woman of God, a very familiar passage of scripture in Isaiah, the first chapter, 18 verse. And the Spirit of the Lord been telling me for 3 days. He said, come, let us reason together. He said, tell the people that I'm setting up an appointment with them now. He said, I'm setting an appointment time now. And see, this is why it's very important that people now move in the Spirit of the Lord when they begin to call revivals. God began to tell me, he said, they begin to have conferences so that they wouldn't confront what comes with a revival. Because with conferences, they can still hide, they sin. Yes, but revival comes to expose what is not right in the people. He said, they have hid behind conferences long enough. He said, revival is in the air. Look at somebody and tell them it's revival time. It ain't time for you to sit at home in your sealed houses anymore. If we ever needed to be in the presence of the Lord, it's right now. If the people could really see what's getting ready to take place upon the earth, we wouldn't even have to ask people to come to church in this hour. I woke up from a voice that kept saying, danger, danger, danger. I said, God, what's getting ready to happen? He said, I'm getting ready to send a shaking throughout the earth. He said, there's getting ready to be a shaking throughout the earth. He said, earth is getting ready to shake. And so the people are trying to figure out what's really going on right now. How did they go shout? But the Lord said, he shouted and everybody they go shout. He said, there's a shaking in the atmosphere right now. Oh my God. There's a move going on right now in the body of Christ. He said, and many of the people are running away from what I have for them. But I heard the Spirit of the Lord say to tell this region, that this region right here, he said, tell them, come. Look at somebody and jump. You better tell somebody they better come. He said, we don't have time to be sitting around trying to be upset with each other. He began to talk to me about that scripture in Isaiah. Lord began to talk to me even about the altar in this hour.
Come on.
And he said, no longer will they come with their real rituals coming before the presence of the Lord with a pretense of repentance.
Come on.
We come into the altar, but we're not turning from sin. Just shake, rattle, and roll. The Lord began to tell me, he said, you got to tell the people now, come now. Come now while I will reason with them. Come now while I'm talking to them. Because there's a move of God that's getting ready to hit the earth where the people of God are going to beg for the real truth of the word of God. There's a famine getting ready to hit. Everybody talking about famine, famine. And God said the prophets can't even see what kind of famine it is. Because they prophesying about another kind of famine, but that's not the famine that's getting ready to come. It's a famine for the move of God. It's a famine for the presence of God. It's a famine coming to the Lord. Oh my God. Now heard the Lord say, I'm not going to show up when I'm against the people that proclaim to know him. It's his people that are causing the eruption in the earth now. The Spirit of the Lord began to talk to me, he said. He said some things are getting ready to be revealed. And he told me to tell the people of God as I was on my way down here, especially in the Georgia area, something about the Georgia area, the enemy is trying to overtake this place with a strong hand, with a strong and a mighty hand. And he said the people are too busy trying to be entertainers.
Come on!
And not preachers.
Come on!
And instead of them getting the people in a place where they can receive from the Lord, they are causing them to miss what God is really doing because they're giving them false hopes. Except we repent.
Come on now. My God.
See, we want to have revivals so people can fall out and shout and dance around.
Come on, Tammy.
We got all this bodily exercise and ain't nobody give deliverance. People falling out, spitting all up on the floor. But there ain't no demons, that's just your food. The Bible is saying now. He said, where are the people that have the ability to cast spirits out? Oh, y'all don't want to say that about that. Look at somebody and tell them, you better come now. You better come now while the door is still open. Because the Lord began to tell me, he said the door is just about to shut. He said, and they're running around here, and we're still running around here and don't even realize that we are in perilous times. Come now, let us reason together. Look at somebody and tell them, you better come while he's talking to you. You better know what God is doing in this.
You got to come while my voice is still talking in the earth. You got to come now when I'm still holding my heart. Hallelujah. Having mercy on the people.
You
get the show.
He
said, come now. Look at somebody and tell them, you better come now. He said, come now and let us reason together, said the Lord. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be white as snow. Though they be red like crimson, they shall be as wool. This is the part. See, they don't connect these two scriptures together. They want to quote number 19, but they want, you know what I'm saying? They skip past 18. And they love to sit up there and tell you, if you be willing and obedient. But they don't understand that it's a requirement that goes with that scripture that's right up above you. And then they don't go down to the end of that chapter to see what's going to happen if you don't obey God. And so they're giving people portions of what God is saying. But they're not giving them the whole load.
All right. Oh, well. Come on.
And so what we're dealing with now is some, you can't even say a half truth. We just got to say it's a whole lie.
Oh, come on.
So what we're dealing with is a whole lie that sounds like a big truth.
Uh-huh. My God.
And so they're fixing up the word of God right now to fit the patterns of sin that we're walking in the church. And the church is in a delusional state because they think that God is justifying all this crookedness and wickedness that's going on in the house of God. Y'all want to say it right there. See, you want to be, you want somebody to come in here and tell you God's getting ready to bless you. But he can't bless you until he gets you to this altar. Oh my God. Look at somebody and tell them, what kind of ashes are you leaving on the altar? Oh my God. The Lord began to tell me, he said, the evidence is going to be when you leave from here, when you leave from Midway, the evidence is going to be how many ashes are left on this altar. Oh, how many people really got delivered? How many people got set free? How many people came out to sin? How many people lies turned around? Is there anybody in here that no one had a shout? I was telling somebody the Old Testament to the New, the people of God were jacked up. But the Bible was not written to the world, it was written to the church. And the things that it's talking about in the Bible are the things that were going on in the church. Y'all were saying they have always dealt in things that were unrighteous. I said the children of Israel, I said everybody want to run around here. No, I ain't going to say that.
Come on, Apostle. Let it rip. Come on.
They're going to be Hebrew and everything. But if you read about them children of Israel,
right there,
they was forever getting into something they didn't have no business. They was ever forever looking for us. Came right out of Egypt. Saw the Red Sea opened up and everything. Saw God bring plague after plague. Saw God kill the firstborn of Pharaoh and his army. And then they turn around, get in the wilderness, and while the man of God is gone for 40 days up in the mountains, trying to get direction from God for them, they begin to make another God. I said, from the time they came out of Egypt, they've been great.
It's the Hebrews. Come on now.
I said, read the word. I said, y'all must ain't read the same word I'm reading. He was forever rebuking me. Forever. He had to take thousands out sometimes to even get their attention. Because they were forever reaching back into sin. Oh, y'all want to say that right there. This ain't no new thing that's going on. They think just because grace is here, they don't got God. But you got a boy. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. What? Oh my God, hallelujah, because, oh my God, because you can be separated eternally from God. I began to look, I said, come, they was always, they was in the witchcraft, they was in the everything. And then you want to sit here and act like you don't understand why they doing the same thing they doing now. It's in the spiritual bloodline. The church. They've been taught for centuries sin and iniquity. Oh my God. Hallelujah. They always have a hard time just singly serving God. And so God said, now I'm going to send my son. Surely they're going to do right if I send my son. Surely they're going to turn from their wicked way if he died and be raised again. Surely they will understand that from the beginning and he was prophesied about. Surely they're going to turn. But these same people that are supposed to love God, know all the laws of God, can quote scripture backwards and forwards. The same people were hollering, crucify him, because he was preaching a gospel that went against their flesh. So the church is always in a battle with good and evil fighting against each other. Those that preach righteousness are blackballed from many of the churches, especially in America, where it's supposed to be the land of the free. Brother, you know. And I was telling somebody, I said, it's mighty strange. Every religion can do whatever it want to do. But when it comes to talking anything about Jesus, there is a problem. Look at somebody and tell them, I'm about to bring a greater problem.
I'm about to bring a greater problem.
He said, come now and let us reason together. He said, I don't just want to send judgment before I talk to my people. I don't just want to loose the death angel and let him just go through the church and kill up everybody that's out of order. Three fourths of the church probably be gone. We have one fourth sitting up. was there. Praying tumors, y'all ain't saying nothing. What is the problem now? Hallelujah, man. I shout, I know it in my side. Where's the people that are able to come together? He said, come now, let us reason. Let us reason. Let us reason together. So the council of God wants to talk to the people of God. The Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost said, we're willing to come and reason with you and talk with you. Huh? We're willing to come and visit your establishments. But the minute they really show up,
come on,
we shut them down.
That's so true.
True. We don't want deliverance in the house of God.
Come on.
How dare us show that people that say that they got God in their life still got spirits they need to be delivered from.
Jesus. That's true. My God.
Glory.
Come on, Father.
I said Jesus was in the temple when he was preaching. He was dealing with a whole lot of stuff.
He sure was.
He had deaf and dumb spirits and everything else. He was walking, evangelizing, meeting up with Legion and everybody else. And we're sitting in the house of God and don't want people to be set free. Because we're afraid that we're going to lose a tithe of offering. Because see, you're going to still push dope because that dope you're bringing in great tithe. Y'all don't say nothing right there. You still want them to be able to push them. You still, y'all ain't saying that. You still want them to be a little crooked on their income tax card. That's extra money you think that's going to come into the house of God. Y'all don't say nothing. Y'all don't say nothing right there. They don't want you to be free. They want you to do anything that is necessary so that you can keep finances going in their dirty little nasty hands. Hallelujah. Look at somebody and tell them, we're going to start shake the hand of the preacher. The preacher can't. ain't saved you. He ain't your savior. She ain't your favor. You must be. He said, Marvel not. You must be born again of the water and the spirit. Some of y'all need to get re-baptized because you didn't know what you were doing when you got baptized.
Stuff.
Gotta dig some stuff out of you tonight.
That's right.
season is still stocked up. Prophesying is stocked up. See, folks don't want you to tell them about their stuff. Then they want to get mad and be rolling their eyes, looking at you all praying like somebody's scared of them. Look at somebody and tell them, ain't nobody scared of you. You and your demons. In the Holy Ghost. Don't draw attention to themselves when they're in the midst of the anointing. They come to hide and do their dirt. They ain't trying to draw no attention to themselves, especially if they know they got people in the midst that know how to get the devil out.
Assignment of that region.
My God. So God said, now They have a word in their mouth that will challenge the spirits that have taken over these places. God began to show me a five-headed dragon. I said, God, God have mercy. I got to go deal with this demon. And it's a five-headed dragon that comes to bring total chaos. That releases all kind of vile spirits in this place. And that's why perversion is so heavy in Georgia.
Yes, it is.
Y'all looking at me strange?
It's the truth.
See, you got to know what you're fighting against.
Yeah.
We just have to revive. When revival comes, it don't just come to revive. It comes to reveal and then give you the power to be able to destroy what God is showing you is taking place. That's why he comes to revive you. So that you can get power to overthrow these demons and devils that are trying to make your life visible in the land of your sight.
Yes.
Hey.
Come on. Speak, Jesus. My God.
No matter what God, God's not going to send you somewhere. Have equipped.
Come on, Jesus. Come on, Pastor.
He equips us before he transitions us. But God began to show me, he said, but when I wanted them to go, they were equipped at that time to handle them. But the enemy got wind they were coming. And he sent reinforcements before they got there. See, Satan know your assignment before you do. Y'all looking at me strange. He stands right there. He knows when you come in this earth, he already recognized what anointing you're going to walk in.
Jesus, Lord.
That's why he assigns a demon that follows you all through your life. If you really look back and notice, you'll notice that there are certain things that always seem to plague your life.
Yes. That's right. That's right.
They were assigned from birth.
Jeez, my God.
And when you're getting ready to go into your assignment of destiny, when God begins to reveal to you who you really are, then those demons then begin to reveal themselves.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
That's good. That's good. That's good.
Yes.
That's good.
My God. Then they reveal themselves because now it's time to attack you so that I can discourage you from being who God called you to be.
Oh, no.
See, that's why the Lord has said, come now, let us reason together, because I need to show you some things that's going to happen once we get everything straight on this altar. Then once I get you straight on this altar, this is what I'm getting ready to do through your life. Now, your real assignment will show up once you lift the ashes of your past on this altar. And I mean all of
them.
Now your real assignment will show up because now you have made up your mind, I'm not going to allow anything to separate me from my yes, Lord. Look at somebody and tell them, you're going to have to get in his time tonight. to go do it when you feel like doing it.
Come on, come on.
You're going to have to learn how to trust him regardless of what you see.
Right.
If he tells you it's time for you to go, then you better be getting your little glad rags together and get on where God wants you to go. Ain't no need of you trying to sit there and try to reason this thing out. You ain't going to never have enough money. It ain't going to never be the right time.
That's right.
So the enemy going to make sure you don't have the finances to do it, and he's going to make sure you have the timing of God when you do it. So when God speaks in this hour, you just got to get up. Because he said, if you be willing to be here, after I get rid of all that stuff in you on the altar. Then he said, if you be willing and obedient, after I get through getting, oh my God, all that stuff out of you, after I get finished, hallelujah, working on your heart and working on your mind. He said, then you are able to be willing and obedient. And if you do that, you will eat the good of the land.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Look at somebody and tell them, you're going to have to get delivered first. Because you're not going to even tell him a good yes if you ain't delivered. I can't tell you how many times I told him yes before I really said yes. Y'all looking at me straight. Y'all trying to sit there and act like the first time he said, yes, you really meant it all the way. No, baby, Because when them trials started hitting that first time, I said, yeah, I backed up. I sure did. I put it in reverse and backed it up, baby. Hallelujah. And I said, oh, wait a minute. Let me rethink this thing, regroup right now. Because you didn't tell me this yes meant that I was going to lose everything. You didn't tell me this yes meant that I was going to be persecuted like that. You didn't tell me this yes meant that I was going to lose, that I was going to be hungry, that I was going to be homeless. You didn't tell me that my yes was going to cause me my family. You didn't tell me that my yes. See, so that first time, that yes wasn't real. Because the minute it hit me, I backed up. I backed up. Y'all would make me strong. I backed up. I didn't backslide, but I backed up. Everything that I used to do. Come on now. I stopped going to church as much because every time it looked like I went, I suffered persecution after the church was over.
Yep.
That would have me strange. Huh? And you know what? My greatest persecution was them older saints.
Right.
That was jealous because God was using me in one day and hadn't used them in 20 years. Once Sister Hedden heard try to tell me I had a demon. Because I started prophesying. They said I wasn't saying long enough. I had to help them out. I said, baby, I didn't know what it was when I was in the world, but I could tell people what was going to happen then. So if that's what you're going on, I've been doing that for years. I just wasn't saying doing it. Now that God using me, how dare you try to shut my mouth up? Them old folks came at me. So they said, and you know what I'm saying? And then nobody had to tell me to, change my attire or nothing. The Holy Ghost talked to me personally because I got a relationship with him. Then nobody had to tell me to start covering up. The Holy Ghost would convict me. When I put on something, I was going to go sauteing up in the church, switching my hips. Some of y'all still switching, don't play.
Well, come on, Father.
And God began to deal with me until my yes became real to me. But baby, I had to suffer for this yes. And that's why I don't care. I don't care if people don't like me. I don't care what going on. Come on. Because I know what my yes cost me. Not once, not twice, three times. I lost everything. God said, walk away from it. How God gonna tell you to walk away from your new car you just got?
My God.
Just gonna took your money and put the furniture throughout your whole house, then he gonna tell you you got to leave and go somewhere with, and don't nobody know you. And tell you you got to go to a place don't nobody know you. And then he send you to a place where the witches live. I thought I went into Dungeons and Dragons. Gonna send me to Louisiana. What the Lord? You send me to Louisiana. Huh? They got rude witches. They got them. They just call up in the service and everything and just be crazy. Stand up while you're preaching and try to cast a spell. You gotta rebuke them openly so that they understand that you're not afraid of. Because fear is what really causes witchcraft to work against you. Fear and intimidation. Because you already got power over it. Rest assured, you do have power over it. But when you become fearful, then those symptoms and everything open up a portal for the enemy to begin to operate in your life. But when you understand who you are and who's on your side, and in my shop, and you ain't got nothing in you that the devil can connect to, you can stand flat-footed and let the devil know. You can come if you want to, but you don't need.
Spoke about, and I'm telling you, we gotta get our stuff in gear like never before.
these giants and these things and begin to tell the people of God that you gotta come out of your sin. You gotta come out your mess. You gotta turn from your wicked way. Hallelujah. Look at somebody and tell. It's time to tell the church the truth.
Chief demon.
that you don't even have. You ain't even got out. You still in track. I've been doing ministry for 13 years. I said, and 12 and a half of it is still messed up. You might just now get ready to come out of your pride. How in the world you talking about you a chief apostle and you scared of a demon in your house? I said, won't you get Jezebel? You can't even deal with that Jezebel in your house. How you gonna come out against somebody? You got somewhere to stand until you get a backbone, go sit down. Come on now, because we gotta stop all this playing. It's time now. Look at somebody and tell them, we gonna tell God to give you some boldness. Some real boldness. They talking about that little stuff where you talk all that junk behind closed doors. I said, I'm going to get some of them one of these days. While they up there at that altar, I'm going to wait till one of them real demons stir up. And then I'm going to push them down on them. You want to act like we got all this power until a real monster show up. Come on now. We need some people that know what they're doing. Look at somebody and tell them it's an altar call time. God calling us back to the altar. Because he got to pull out of us anything that the enemy can use as a weapon against us when we get ready to stand before Satan's kingdom. We got to come to the altar and get that out. Ain't no shame in it, baby. I don't care what nobody said. When I got ready to be delivered, I made my own altar call. While the preacher was up there preaching, I just looked like something picked me up out of my chair and threw me on the altar. Baby, I made my own altar call. Told God to deliver me from everything. Lord, please take this temper, because if not, I'm going to shoot somebody.
Well,
in the church.
Okay.
In the church.
Right.
So you got to take this temper from me, because if you don't take this temper from me, or either sanctify it or something, don't take it all the way, God, because I'm going to need to come up against these demons. I can't be no scared kid. I don't want to be no scared kid. Now, come on. But we gotta make up a mind. But I told God, I said, you gotta fix me now. Come on now. I know struggles. Some of the struggles people go through. I know what it means. They have to give up a good man. Because you got Christ in your life.
My God. Come on.
Yep, my God, so he didn't want me.
That's right.
Some of y'all probably could have married yours, but I wasn't gonna marry nobody, and they was telling me about warfare with the devil, and I know that they weren't saved, so I know the devil was in them.
Right.
So I wasn't gonna marry my warfare. He was selling drugs, and I was selling drugs at the time when I got saved. What I'm gonna go and marry him for, I'm coming out of it. And I'm going to marry him. And see, that's why some of these preachers, I want to slap them from telling people to marry folks just because you was with them when you got saved. Don't mean that that's your husband or that's your wife. Because we make mistakes in sin. Y'all looking at me straight? Yeah, we make mistakes in sin. I wasn't bit more seeking God when I got that man. Don't even try to play me like that. Don't try to tell me what you know. God ain't put that together, baby. We got together over some Hennessy. We got them together because no God. What? I was drunk. Drunk when I got that man, please. He gave me a drink. Come on. God put us together. No, he didn't. That was that Hennessy that was talking to me. Telling me he's the best looking man in town. And when I got sober, I found out that was a lie. Y'all was looking at me straight. Let me tell you something. Sin will make anything look good to you. Sin will make anything look good to you. Y'all sit up here. Y'all know y'all don't got had some encounters with somebody that was ugly as sin. Now, if you got off no high after that, you don't came off of that blood and everything, when you looked over there, together. No, he didn't put mine together. Praise the Lord. I was high and drunk. No, look at that be strong. When God saved me, he delivered me and set me free. Look at somebody and tell them, you got to know who's on your side. Now look at that, be strength. That was wrong with you. You don't want to be transparent and tell people the struggles you went through. So I know what it feels like when women say they don't have a man, had to give up a man. And then you turn up there trying to tell them that they got a demon. They ain't no demon. That's just part of life, baby. You're going to feel something. They got a demon in them. Holy Ghost know how to keep you, though.
Yes.
If you want to be kept.
Yes.
I got my last baby because I didn't want to be kept in the church.
Come on now.
While I was working on the prayer line. Get somebody to tell them, come, come, come. Hallelujah. That's what the Lord is saying tonight. Come. Let us reason together. Because I want to deliver you. Because I want to set you free.
Yes.
I know there's some struggles in here. I don't ever preach something and it's not in the house. So somebody dealing with some stuff in their flesh. Somebody having a battle. If it ain't nothing but the enemy bringing thoughts. Trying to make you do something. Trying to make you take a drink. Trying to make you pick up the phone and call Lil Willie.
Now,
don't let me strike.
Yes, you in the house. You in the house.
Dealing with some stuff.
Yes, it's real.
Dealing with some stuff. And I'm not no more shocked. But God wanted to deliver me. I'm telling you. Because some of you, and I'm not no more shocked. You're behind time and God wanted to use you.
Thank God.
You're supposed to be in a place now. Some of y'all should be traveling all over this world. But you allow the enemy to put you in an afflicted place. And see, he'll make things come to cause you to feel ashamed. So that you won't make the effort to do what God said, because the enemy keeps replaying a shame before your face. But the Bible tells me who the Son makes free is free indeed. And there is therefore now no condemnation to them who are in Christ Jesus. It ain't no condemnation.
Come on,
Apostle. I'm not condemned anymore. You can't condemn me because now I'm in Christ Jesus. And I'm perfect in Him. I'm perfect in Him. And then Paul sums this up and he begins to tell them, you don't understand. I got a problem, but His grace is sufficient. Because when I'm weak, then He's strong.
Thank you.
speak in tongues. They don't even understand the tongues is not really the evidence. It's just a part of it to let people that are in there know. If you understand, if you read it, what they was talking about in the book of Acts, when they began to speak in tongues, they were speaking in everybody's language to let them understand that the Lord was in the house. The evidence of being filled is the attributes, the fruits of the Spirit. That's your evidence. We can't go on tongues, baby. Because we got lying tongues. So we can't go on tongues no more. There might have been a time we might have thought we had it. But now I need to see the fruits that they talk about in Galatians.
Yes.
God, like y'all understand.
Right.
Where your love at?
Right.
You ain't got no long suffering. Every Sunday you up testifying. I can't hardly take nothing. Come go on. Sit down somewhere.
Yeah. Come on, Pastor.
I mean, you gotta have patience to run this race.
Yeah.
You gotta have patience to run this race. Because everything that the enemy could sin against you, he's gonna sin. Lift your hand and say, God, help me to be real now. Some of y'all didn't even lift your hands. You didn't open your mouth. Open your mouth and say, Lord, help me to be real now.
Help me to be real now.
Come on, man. Shout. For some of you right now, the Lord is getting ready to shift your old atmosphere. I heard him say there's about to be a change in your circumstances. And he's just not talking about you going through financially. He's talking about your life, baby. Even your whole lifestyle is about to change. Some of you have been anointed from the womb of your mother. And the enemy have tried to take what you have been anointed to do out of you. And he wants you to know tonight that he's getting ready to stir it up this night. Look at somebody and tell him he's about to stir it up. That God allows the apostles to be able to do and makes to stir up the gift that's within you.
Come on, apostles. That's it. Love it.
So we are able to stir up the gift that's within you.
Jesus.
Jesus. Activation service. And don't even know what to activate. You don't get them spirits all in there. What you activate? A murder spirit? Pedophile spirit? Spirit of lust? What you activate?
That's good right there.
God want to do something because even some of you young people, I'm telling you, God began to tell me, he said that the age is from 40 down. He's getting ready to move upon them in a powerful way. There's getting ready to be a mighty move in that age bracket right there. They're getting ready to, hey, my shot. They're getting ready to cuff shot. They're getting ready to experience the trueness of God's power. The Spirit of the Lord began to tell me, he said, there's some young people, he said, they're crying out for the realness of God.
Come on,
they're not wonderful shot. And see, we get and we see them in church, and when they're trying to get the Lord, when they're trying to get deeper relationship, the older folks discourage them.
Yes, they do.
And we're losing them back into things. And that's why. Because we're too busy trying to get them dressed up and look like us.
Come on now.
I told one, I said, no, I don't want you. Nobody be marrying after you with your mean self. Put nobody in your hand. You mean. You're going to kill all the young people. He called you to this altar. Let's get this demon out.
Say it, Apostle. Right there.
This generational thing that's in you. Come on.
Oh my God.
And the Lord began to tell me the young people are getting ready to be set on fire like we ain't never seen before. What they're doing is they're looking for, the Timothys are looking for a Paul.
Yeah.
And what the young men are doing right now are they are joining but older men to learn the wisdom, because they're finding out they need the wisdom and the knowledge and understanding. They might have the gifts, but they need the wisdom and the knowledge and the understanding of how to operate in what God has given them.
Yes.
And so they're not looking for men that's going to turn them out. They're not looking for men that's going to turn them out. They're trying to attach to men that has wisdom to help them get to where they need to go, because they understand it's something greater than what the people are showing us, because they're experiencing some things in the power of God. Let me tell you something. Most prophets deal with major spirits, especially spirits of perversionism. They deal with them real, real heavy. Because the enemy wants to pervert that more than anything. Because he wants us to miss the voice of God. And so the enemy is trying his best to try to take away the identity of man. And that's why there's such an effeminate spirit that's in the body of Christ now. I be telling them, brother, I need you to fix your hand, baby. I'm going to need you to get you some pants that are a little bit more loose.
That's right.
You ain't got no business having no skinny jeans on.
That's right.
That's a feminine move.
Yes, it is.
I'm going to look in them.
That's the truth.
Even the fashion industry is pushing towards that. And that's why the saints of God that have the power to get wealth need to start getting them some businesses in the fashion industry. So that we have somewhere to go shop that doesn't cater to the ways of the world, but will know what God might and will design and create.
Hallelujah.
We're supposed to be the leading force, the church. In these arenas, in these seven mountains. We're supposed to be the leading force there. We're supposed to be the ones that set the pattern. That things, how things are supposed to be. But now we're following behind the world instead of the world following behind us. And so there's a spirit that wants to come and destroy our male figures. Because one thing the enemy does, and people think it's all about that, but it's about them not being able to create, is what he's after.
That's it.
He's after the seed of man.
The seed. Come on, Apostle.
They missed it all together. They're after the seed of man. So he perverts the act that God created for us to have seed to come forth. So he's after the seed of man. So we got to begin to pray for our men.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Ain't none of you women saying no. Whatever God called you to do, there is going to be some dimension of warfare.
Yeah.
I don't care if you sit in the pew, you're going to experience some warfare.
Because you
don't change partners. I hear people say, I didn't have no problem until I got saved. Well, you didn't have no problem because Satan had no reason to bother you.
That's right.
Come on now. We don't even need to discern on that. You don't deal with him no more. So yes, he's gonna fight you.
Yeah.
If your hands say, God, help me to be real now.
God,
get ready to do something. This young man right here, I want you to stand, young man. God, get ready to do some great things.
You have just finished listening to the media ministry of Apostle Barbara R. Thomas. You may write her at Apostle Barbara R. Thomas, P.O. Box 13291, Durham, North Carolina 27709. Thank you for supporting the ministry.